I hope you enjoyed your top three at six, and the band just fading off your background right now. That is Murphy's Flow. They are right here from the 254. Some suone to wanaka walaitwa Light TV Mweleni International. Na na na, they are very local. Ati niwasapere limu. Shout out guys for tuning in. The show is Rock Tour Live right here on White 54 TV. The hashtag is Rock Tour 254. Keep talking to us at Philin June. That's on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and at White 54 channel at Rock Tour 254. Go like our pages, manze. Like the Twitter, like the Facebook. Rock Tour 254. And of course, we have at Hugh Skills. That's on Facebook, Twitter, and on Instagram, Hugh Skills 1. Yeah. Now, before we even continue, we still have Abdul in studio, but before we continue, I'm gonna shout out a few people who are right here, and they have very important questions that I need to ask Abdul. Now we have Shelton Holywave, who's saying, play me Holywave music, usilenge.
Holywave music,
yes,
Holywave music. Sawa, tuendele.
All right, and then we have Ian Musa Muriuki. He's saying, totally loving the show from South B. Shout out to South B. Yeah, shout out to you guys. I love when he's saying, any Breaking Benjamin will make my evening. Hey, Breaking Benjamin,
yeah.
All right, we have Davis Kirogo on a too good and real. That's what we're all about. We're all about good music.
That's all about
and good, just good music and real music. And talking about real issues and good stuff that affect the youth. Now we have Hesbon Mangiti and Asimandani Kamakawa. LD is the place to be. Shout out to Eldoret. We'll be coming to Eldoret. These are the plans we have for you. You guys are not even ready. You're not ready. The show is Rock Tour, so that tells you something. We're gonna have a tour. We're gonna have to tour, and LD is gonna be definitely one of the places we'll be visiting. Now I have Mo Wawambo. Mo. That's my locked out of Moraka. Massive mad love. We have so much love for you too. Thank you so much for staying tuned. We appreciate each and every one of you. I have Shelton Holywave, Shoikolit. There's a video, there's a YouTube link. We're gonna have to open that and check it out later. Iman James, a big shout out to you. He's always tuned, but he's like the biggest fan of the show. We appreciate you. Anasema nawacheki venye mnapigwa na bumbuazi ya kufunga.
Haya, sasa kaka, tumekubali. Lakini tunafundishwa. Next time,
auliza, muulize. Is it Ramadan or Ramadan? You get the point. Dan with the D-A-N or Ramadan? And the D-H-A-N. Well, Abdul will be telling us that. No, there are people who actually write Ramadan, and there are people who write Ramadan. So Abdul will be telling us that. And then I have someone else who says, Filin and Huskis Mutafungalini.
Sisi. Dan, mshipi ama.
Mazie.
Tufunge mshipi ama.
Apo bakufunga. Tutajua. All right, we have Conqueror Sala. He's saying one love show eco fire. Moto fire passy, that one.
Oh, moto fire passy, sir.
Moto fire passy, moto, you know. That one. Shout out to you. Thank you so much for watching. Now, Son Spare. Okay, it's not Son. It's actually Son. My bad. I said Son Spare. Why is it Son? Because it's a name. I'm not sure. Son Spare. I'm an Ispare.
Spare.
As my normal son, shout out to you, bro. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm producer Maguts to Babu. I say my fire moto. Thank you so much. Now, John Matthews, he's saying, tuning in from Nyeri, love the show. Please play for me any Slayer. His name is John Matthews. You've got you. Don't worry. You're going to be playing that metal. I realize so many people love metal, So, Abdul, we have so many questions now. I still have many guys to shout out. Don't worry. I'm not going to forget you. If you're on the timeline, don't worry. We'll still show you some love. Now, Abdul, start with Ramadan. Is it Ramadan? Is it Ramadan? Yeah, tell us. What's the difference?
There is no difference. It's a matter of transliteration. Now, transliteration refers to taking text from a totally different writing system into the English alphabet. For instance, when you're writing in Arabic, there is this letter called Dhal, which does not exist in English. It's Dhal. Now, transliterating it into English, it becomes DH. Dhan. Ramadan. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to say something that's a little bit unfamiliar to many people.
Right.
For those who speak Spanish or understand Spanish, they will know that the letter D in Spanish is never D. Mm-hmm. You don't say D. Mm-hmm. It's the. So, for instance, I'll give you one word, like the word right, R-I-G-H-T in English, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
In Spanish, it's written as verdad. But
verdad.
To pronounce it, you don't say verdad, you say verdad.
Verdad.
Like Madrid. They don't say Madrid, they say Madrid.
Madrid.
Yeah.
It's like my name. Philippe Jean, yeah?
Yeah.
In Kenya, we say Jean, but in French, it's Jean. Yeah? You guys, Jean.
I understand it was just like trying to take Shakespeare English and put it into standard English. Yeah?
Uh-huh.
First guys were Shakespeare.
Or Greek. Yeah. And
that
makes sense. So we get, but they all mean the same thing. Mm-hmm. Now I have another question from a man James who's asking. Kindly ask Abdul, is it bad for a Muslim to listen to secular music?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
First of all, he's a rock star. Yeah, remember that he's a rocker.
Reaction.
Yeah.
There is this reaction on my face.
Yeah.
And then I've crossed my fingers. Again, I'll be very honest here.
Mm-hmm.
When I started the show, I mentioned so many very...
Yeah, and you have a show that is Al Nasheed.
Al Nasheed.
Yeah, and you play music, yeah.
We're not going to delve so much into Islamic music because of...
There
is that. Now, secular music, I'll take some references from the Quran where Satan says to the Almighty Allah, he says, give me all the time in the world and I'll go and deceive people on earth. And then he says... One of the tools I'm going to use is instruments. Mm. I'm going to use my voice to mislead people on earth.
Very true.
Yeah.
So
I think that's even in the Bible, right? Yeah, it's yeah.
And in the Bible, people say that Lucifer was the best musician in heaven.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, but now, once again, there is this reaction on my face. There is this reaction on my face. Yeah. So that's basically it. It's not allowed because... It says in the Quran, in Arabic, it says "Wala tattabi'u hudwatan shaytan," which means do not follow the steps of Satan. And one of the steps of Satan is listening to music and all the temptation that it throws to us.
Yes, on that note, actually, apparently, as in getting it from the history now, apparently now Muslims are embracing music more.
Yeah.
Currently, by the
and DJ also, Khaled.
Even the messages you'll find that they sing. We have some Muslims who are singing, the Quran, which is really cool. And then now coming now to my side, rock music. We have some serious rock bands which are Muslim. Also some serious metal bands.
Yeah,
which are
that are. That
so
that
I was like, now what's the approach here? And
When I started producing Al Nasheed. Before I stepped aside from being the producer of the show and becoming the presenter.
And just to cut you short, in East Africa, the reigning king of, the Wasafi crew, he's Muslim, Diamond Platnumz. We have we have Red Sun.
Yeah.
We have Ali Kiba as well, he's Muslim. So, Nandi,
There is being a Muslim and there is practicing Islam. Now these are two different things. You can be a Kenyan and you can also be
non-patriotic
Kenyan.
Or you can be a Kenyan who doesn't even live in Kenya.
For example, like, those who say Nafumilia kwa Kenya.
Exactly.
So you can be a patriot and you're a Kenyan, or you can just be a Kenyan who's not a patriot.
Yeah.
That's the same case. You can find Muslims who are just, we call them Waislamujina, those who are just Muslims, but they do not practice Islam. Exactly. And then there are those Muslims who are really staunch. Long beards, not like mine, longer than mine, and they wear the kameez or the kanzu, and they perform everything in Islam. So we cannot say that just because DJ Khaled is a Muslim and he DJs secular music, it's allowed for Muslims to do that. So there is the being a Muslim and practicing Islam.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, so Abdul, I understand time ya kufuturu ishafika. Time ya kufungua.
Who wants to join me?
Time ya kufungua ishafika.
Yeah, which one of you wants to join me?
We'll do that. But now we're still doing the shows.
Kufungua.
Time ya kufuturu ishafika. It's time. So
I think I want to be in that part.
But you're the one who's playing. He's playing music.
He's playing music, so you can go. Understand. Philip, you'll eat on his behalf.
Yeah, I'll eat on your behalf. So here's the thing. Before we go, today we're talking about mothers, and I want to know your perspective on that, because we still have our Muslim sisters and mothers. Yeah, what's your take? Yeah. How does religion, or you just as a Muslim, how do you view your women? Because you have very many speculations of human or okay, wakubaliwi, sijui kufanya nini. How is it right now? Like, how are women viewed? And what's your take on Mother's Day?
Well, Mother's Day is a very important day.
Yeah.
Because it acknowledges the importance of mothers and it appreciates them.
Right.
And there is nothing more important and better than appreciating someone for the efforts that they have made, whether it's a mother or not.
Yeah.
But now that it appreciates mothers, let's get to the Islamic perspective of women in Islam and how mothers are viewed. Now, there is this hadith of one Sahaba, or one companion of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who came to the Prophet and asked him, who should I give respect and honor to after Allah and the Prophet of the Almighty Allah, who is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? And then he said, your mother.
See?
That was the response.
I talked about that.
You mentioned that.
I mentioned it.
Like, yes, you have done some very good research. You've done some very good research.
Yeah.
The hadith goes on, and this guy asks again, who should I give my respect and honor to after the Almighty Allah and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? And then the Prophet says, for the second time, your mother.
Yeah.
And then he asks again for the third time, and the Prophet says, your mother. And now this companion is not satisfied, so he asks for the fourth time this question. And now the answer comes, your father. So the mother has been mentioned three times, and the father has been mentioned only one time. Well, we know fathers are really important. Let's just carry on with the mother perspective.
Yeah.
In the Quran, it says that heaven is beneath the feet of your mother.
Yeah.
Right beneath the feet of your mother. Perfect. Which means that you're supposed to respect your mom and be very obedient towards them. And also one more thing to emphasize on the importance of mothers. Now, this is to do with both parents, which says all children are supposed to obey their parents, even if they're old. Even if they become old and sickly and disgusting, do not say to them, "Ugh." And then there is this Arabic exclamation. I know many people have come across it. That oof. Do not say that to them as well. It has been specifically mentioned, don't
say that to your mom.
To your parents.
Oh, now, your parents. Yeah. Oh, all right.
And now we remember all this levels which we've described mothers at. Yeah. So it's very important to appreciate your mother, and not only in this Mother's Day celebration, but also across your entire existence.
Yeah, throughout the year. You don't just respect them once, you have to respect them throughout 365 days.
I want to allude to something very funny here. Mm-hmm. You know, there's this joke which always goes like, when the child is so smart, performing well in sciences, parents
does it. The dad. That is my son.
That's my son.
That's my blood.
And then when you perform, when you start performing badly, they'll say,
mama.
Let's allude to something very important here. There is no father tongue.
Yeah.
There is no fatherland. It's always motherland. And mother tongue.
Imagine. Even the nature, like the nature itself, they call it Mother Nature. No one says Father Nature is upset. We are doing this to Father Nature. Yeah, so moms are very important. And thank you so much for your time and for coming.
Yeah, it's love, Maze. Yeah. We've been school here. We've really been school, Maze. It's been a serious class.
All right, yeah.
Dope stuff.
You know, and all of us here, we're present because of the moms. They gave us life, Maze. That labor pain. Like, it takes a lot. The least you can do is at least respect your mom.
Yeah.
And celebrate her. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. Yes, and there's no child without a mother, you know.
They taught us who our fathers are.
Yes, exactly. You get to learn that. But mothers are very, very important to this society. Really cool. So I think we're going to go back to music, and then we're going to come back with more show. We have band profile. We have events that are happening. We have freshman. So maybe just one or two music, and then we come. Oh, I think we go with band profile
as you say, madam.
Right, yes. And on band profile, it's an African affair. It's an African thing, yeah? I love it when you're profiling bands that are from from maybe Kenya and Africa at large. And today we go all the way to Tunisia. Tunisia, yes. Yeah. So today's band, they go by the name of Mirath.
Mirath.
Uh-huh. And Mirath basically just means legacy.
Yes, today, exactly.
Mirath means legacy.
Shall we say?
Yeah.
Which language?
Tunisian.
Okay.
Right, so Tunisian. Mirat means legacy. What? Now.
Arabic.
Yeah, it's Arabic.
Yeah, it's Arabic. Yeah.
Mirathi.
Yeah.
Actually, that's them.
Yes.
Exactly.
We chose it because it's Muslim oriented.
Yes.
Or Arabic oriented.
Arabic oriented.
Arabic oriented.
All right. So let me just tell you one or two things about them so that we can release Abdul to go and, you know, Afuture.